Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Come on and magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Amen. Praise the Lord on this wonderful Wednesday. Amen. Wow. Worship on Wednesday. Are there any worshipers in the house on tonight? Hallelujah. Giving praises to the Almighty. Almighty God, the risen Savior, amen. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. To the angels of this house, Apostle Ross, Lady Ross, come on, let's celebrate them on this evening. And to all of you, my Father's children. Amen. We're going to read from 1 Thessalonians, the 5th chapter. I'm going to begin at the 14th verse. Amen. It's so good to see the body of believers on this evening. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. And we're already ready. 1 Thessalonians 5 and the 14th verse. And the word of God declares, "Now we exhort you, brethren, warn them that are unruly, comfort the feeble-minded, support the weak, be patient to all men. See that none render evil for evil unto any man, but either follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. Rejoice evermore." Where are my rejoicing people at? "Pray without ceasing. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Quench not the spirit, despise not prophecies, prove all things, hold fast that which is good, abstain from all appearances of evil, and the very God of peace sanctify you wholly, and I pray God your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ." And the word of God is already blessed. Amen. Amen. Praise God. And we're going to welcome the prophetess up as she come and carry us before the throne.
Every head bow and every eye closed. Thank you, Jesus. God, we just want to tell you thank you tonight, God. God, we just want to tell you thank you for looking beyond our faults and meeting every one of our needs, God. God, if there be anything in us that's not like you, God, we ask that you would take it out and deliver us and strengthen us on today, God. God, because we know that it's through you that we move, live, and we have our very being on today, God. God, we ask that you would saturate us with your presence on today, Father God. We ask that you would open up our mind and help us to begin to dissect the word on tonight, Father God. God, that we would be good stewards over what you have given us on tonight, Father God. God, we ask, God, you said that in your word that in all of our getting, get in understanding, Father God. God, help us to understand your word even the more on tonight, Father God. And God, we bind every hindering spirit of the devil right now. We cancel it and we call it into naught right now. In the name of Jesus, and we plead the precious blood of Jesus against it right now. In the name of Jesus, God. For you said the weapons of our warfare is not carnal, but mighty through you, God, to the pulling down of stronghold, God. And we pull down every stronghold of the enemy on tonight, Father God. And God, we ask that you would have your way on tonight, God. Have your way like never before in the name of Jesus, God. God, I lift up the man and woman of God on tonight, Father God. God, I ask that you would strengthen them where they may be weak, Father God. Build them up on every leaning hand, God. Help the church to undergird them even the more, Father God, in the name of Jesus, God. Oh, God, we say yes to your will. We say yes to your way on tonight. God, we may be few in number, but you said what the Spirit of the Lord is, God. There is liberty, God. God, I thank you for liberty in the house tonight, Father God. God, I thank you that we're free in our spirits, oh God, that we're free to flow, God. We're free to move. We're free to receive, Father God. in the name of Jesus, God. We just want to tell you thank you today, God. We just want to tell you thank you, God. Thank you for looking beyond our faults, God, and meeting every one of our needs on tonight, God. In the name of Jesus, God, give traveling grace to those that are on their way on tonight, Father God. God, we ask this in your Son Jesus' name that we pray. We thank you and amen.
Amen. Come on as you remain standing on your feet for some praise and worship. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. I'm ready for you to stand back up on your feet for some praise and worship. Amen. Amen. If you would, find a neighbor. Go hug somebody and tell them it's good to see you as our media team gets ready for some praise and worship. Find somebody you didn't come with. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Give God a hand praise. Amen. Praise the Lord. We are now in the hands of our media team.
Lord, you're mine. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, give the Lord a hand praise if you can. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord on tonight. Amen. Give God glory for all of you out on tonight. Amen. Good to see some faces I hadn't seen in a while. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. We thank God for his word on tonight. We're going to finish up what we started last week, with the 10 kingdom keys of maturity, of growing up. Amen, somebody. Somebody say, we got to grow up. Amen, we got to grow up. We can't stay babies. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. We thank God for our growth. Amen. Praise the Lord. You got to know that you're not where you used to be. You might not be where we should be, but we're not where we used to be. Amen. So we are growing each and every time we come out. We are growing regardless of what, you know, the enemy may want you to believe. You are getting better. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? Well, the devil wants us to make us think that we ain't getting no better. We still stuck in the same. No, the devil is a lie. No, each and every time we come into his presence, we get better. Amen? It may not have manifest yet. Come on, somebody. But we are getting better. We want to open up tonight with Matthew 16, verse 19. Matthew 16, verse number 19, and we're going to read it together. Amen. Is it on the screen yet? All together. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. Amen. Amen. We thank God for us for holding the divine word. You may be seated. Amen. We're dealing with 10 keys, and God said he will give us to the kingdom. Amen. Amen. So last week we dealt with the first five keys, and we must understand always about what a key grants us access. Amen. When you have a key, you don't knock anymore. Praise the Lord. Amen. When we have a key, we don't have to knock anymore. We have granted access to that door. Praise the Lord. The Word of God says that whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatsoever you shall loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. The reason a lot of things are not happening and a lot of changes are not going on in our lives because we're not practicing binding and loosing. It's just a scripture we read, but we really don't practice it. Come on, somebody. Huh? Instead of binding and loosing, you know, spirits, what we do, we just talk about spirits. Uh-oh. I'm going to pray for you. Can't pray for a spirit. Oh, man, you can't pray for a spirit. You can't pray for a spirit. They can only be bound or loosed. And if you're not binding them, then you're just giving them free rein to be loose. And to be honest with you, the spirits, evil spirits, to be more precise about it, are running rampant. in our lives because we're not, say, binding and loosing. A few years back, I taught about binding and loosing. Maybe that's what I need to do again, maybe, to go over how to bind and loose, because it says bind and loose in this scripture for a purpose, because sometimes folks bind, but they don't loose nothing behind it. And you have to bind and loose. You just can't bind an evil spirit and not loose the Holy Spirit or a godly spirit to take its place. Because if you don't do that, then the scripture comes to Jesus talking how the spirit left out of the house and the house was swept clean and garnished. Then he came back and he found that it was empty. It was nothing in the house. And so he went and got seven more spirits and came back in. So it was not enough to bind. You have to bind and loose. You have to fill that void with something else. For example, you got to bind the spirit of lying, but you need to loose the spirit of truth. You don't, the lying spirit coming right back. Hallelujah. Let's review the first five keys we dealt with last week. The first key was you got to be able to hear from God. Amen. Moses was chosen not because he was a great speaker, but because he was a good hearer. We must be able to hear from God. That's number one. Number two, we must trust in God. We must trust in God. Amen. Number three is we must yield our will. We must yield to his will. It has to be about what God wants for me instead of what I want for me. Amen. Because he has a plan, then we have a plan, and those two plans can't work at the same time. Amen. You can only work one plan at a time. You know, he said, I know the plans and the thoughts that I have for you to prosper you, amen, to bring you to an expected end. This is the plan God has for us. But until we get a revelation of that plan, all we know to do is to work our plan. Amen, somebody. And our plan always end up with destruction and disappointment. Disappointed with theyself. Have you ever just been disappointed with you? Come on, somebody. Man, my Lord, I'm messed up. I need Jesus. I need a Savior because, you know, every time I feel like I try to do right, man, I just sit up. And I'm thinking I'm doing right. Because you're working your plan, not his plan. You know, you can do a God thing, good thing, and it still not be godly. What's that noise? That's water pressure, ain't it? That's water pressure. You check into that, brothers. We don't want nothing to blow up. Amen. Jesus. Praise the Lord. Amen. And we lose the spirit of correct operation, amen, in all things, amen. All things working as they should, amen, properly, by design, in Jesus' name. Number four was we must know how to endure hardness. We're going to have to go through some valleys. We can't stay on the mountaintop. Amen. Somebody go check into that, please. Not want no copy. Amen. Number five. Forgive and get over the offense. We got to forgive and get over the offense. Forgive and get over the offense. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Okay, so we're picking up tonight with number six when dealing with the 10 keys to maturity and growing up in the kingdom. Number six, I might have said I got to give. I have to be a giver. Amen. God is a giver. We're the most like God when we're loving and giving. Amen. These are the two most prominent traits of God. He loves and he gives. Amen. John 3:16 said, God so loved the world that he what? Love prompts us to give. Amen. And we give because we love. Come on, somebody. So those two things work together. And if we're going to grow up, we must learn how to be givers. You can tell when somebody is growing up because, like I said, they go from being selfish and they start being givers, more giving. Amen? Because when we're children, it's all about us. Remember we talked about last week about being selfish. It's mine, it's mine, it's mine. But as we grow up, we learn that it is more blessed to give than to receive. Amen? You know, it does feel better when you can give someone something and they really enjoy it versus you getting something. Amen, somebody. That's called growing up. That's called being mature. It's not about me anymore. I get joy out of seeing other people happy from what I give. Now you're growing up. Amen. Praise the Lord. So we must be givers. Let's look at Luke's Gospel 6 and verse number 38. Luke 6, verse 38. Luke 6, verse 38. Give, and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down and shaken together and running over, shall men give into your bosom. For what measure, for with the same measure that ye meet withal, it shall be measured to you again. Amen. This is Jesus teaching us about giving. We must be givers. And as Christians, we got to get around that our living is based on our, not our earning. Come on, somebody. My living is based on my giving. In the kingdom. Now, we're talking about the kingdom. We ain't talking about the world no more. In the kingdom, my living is based on my giving. Because what I give is going to be given back to me. But not just giving back to me what I gave, but it's going to be pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Amen, somebody. So if our living ain't what it should be, the Word of God teaches us that we need to begin to give more. Not save more. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Because he dealt harshly with the servant that he gave the talent to, and all he did was save it. Come on, somebody. Amen. Because that's not how you increase. You get increased by spitting it out, by giving, and it comes back to you. That's how God increases you. If you never give nothing, he can't increase you. In the kingdom now. We're talking about in the kingdom. Now, you got a whole lot of folk that can save money and have money, okay, but all they have is what they saved. They don't have nothing that God added to it. See, they could have had a 30, 60, or 100-fold what they have if they had a gave instead of just always saving. Amen. Acts 17, verse number 28. Well, in him, we live and move and have our being. As certain also of your own poets have said, for we are also his offspring. Amen. You can't do nothing without the help of the Lord. Amen, somebody. I don't care how smart you think you are, with your degree, went to school, and this, that, and the other. I went to school, got a degree, had a pretty good career, but there came a point in time when I couldn't even find a job with all the knowledge that I had. Amen? So we can't do anything without him. Amen. We can't do nothing without him. So we need to always begin to always acknowledge him. He said, acknowledge him in all thy ways. Amen. Not just in some of our ways, but in all thy ways. Amen. So whenever we give, we're supposed to what? Acknowledge him in our giving, in everything that we give. Amen. Be it our time, our talents, or our treasure. Amen. We need to acknowledge him and make sure what we're doing is pleasing in his eyesight. And I want to pause and say this right here. We have to be prayerful and also mindful in where we give, who we give to. Amen. Now, everything don't have a harvest. Good point, son. Because, you know, depending on where you sow, determine whether you get a harvest or not. You sow in bad ground, the word of God says it ain't nothing coming back from that. Are y'all still with me? So you got to make sure that we're sowing into good ground when we sow. Because if you sow into bad ground or stony ground, I mean it's gonna spring up, but it's going to die. Are y'all with me? Only the good ground produced 30, 60, and some 100-fold. What are you saying, Pastor? I mean, let me help you make it a little more clear to you sometime, a little more clear to you. As much as you love your loved ones, some of your loved ones ain't good ground. And when you give to them, it ain't coming back. I ain't saying you ain't supposed to help them, because God said we're supposed to help folk in need, we're supposed to help the poor, but don't be expecting nothing to come back from that. You know the lifestyle they living? Are y'all still with me? They ain't trying to do nothing for God. You can't get them to come to church for no reason at all. It is what it is. It's not good ground. So don't expect nothing to come back from that. We're supposed to help people, though. Amen? So it's good to help. But just know you're not going to reap a harvest from that. What you will reap is help from that. Because what you're doing to others, God, it comes back to you. So one day, somebody will help you out, just like you helped them out. But it's not going to produce no hundredfold. Are y'all with me? Amen. Praise the Lord. When we grow up, we must be learned to begin to teach what we have been taught. God is teaching us so we can teach others. He's not just teaching us, giving us knowledge, wisdom, and understanding for us to hoard it to ourselves. No, it's to share with others. Amen. We must learn how to teach what we have been taught. And the number one way of teaching is by example, not by lecture. People pick up more from examples, from lectures, because you can grasp it, you can see it better. I can see that. Well, I can see that. Amen. You know, a lot of times we miss a whole lot of opportunities to teach people because of fear sometimes. We're afraid to stand up on our job and just tell somebody, no, that ain't right what you just did. What you just said wasn't right. We supposed to correct people. You think Jesus would just sit there and let somebody, you know, mistreat somebody and he not say nothing? No, he wouldn't do that. Come on, somebody. But we do it all the time. And the cop-out is, well, I just pray for him. Well, you can pray for him too and tell him what they wrong, you know. Guess what? Think about it. You'd still be messed up the way you were if somebody didn't take time out to say, hey, let me tell you something. Shh, come here. And all God expects us to do is do unto others that has been done unto us. Come on, somebody. Somebody helped us out. Somebody let us sit us down and try to tell us what's right. We're supposed to do the same thing. Now, it ain't up to us It ain't up to us whether they receive it or not. Because, see, I'm only responsible for what I say, not for what you hear. Are y'all still with me? But I do have responsibility as a Christian to wherever I see wrong, and I know it's wrong, I have an obligation to say something to try to make it right. Teach what you've been taught. We can't reproduce something that we are not. So, if you know you're not at a level to where you can teach, then just don't say nothing because you ain't there. Are y'all still with me? Teachers first are good students. Good students. Man, and everybody in church are not good students. Everybody are not good students when it comes to the word. What's a good student? A good student is one that pays attention. Now, that's about 50% of the church gone right there. They pay attention. Come on, somebody. Huh? The next good quality of a good student is they have a desire to learn. And somebody that think they know it all don't have no desire. Oh, shucks now. I already know that. Once you tell yourself that, you gone. I done already studied that. You gone. No. Nobody has it all. Amen. And then the next quality of a good student, third quality of a good student, is that they meditate on what they have heard. Amen. So those three things is what really helps, you know, to grow and mature. You know, you pay attention, you have a desire to learn, and you meditate on what you've heard. You replay it. You restudy it. You restudy that. Come on, somebody. You keep it going to make sure that you got it. Huh? You study for the test. That's how you're able to pass the test. To study for it, to go over it again. Are y'all with me? So when you pass the test, you can't have your notes. Well, sometimes when you have a test, sometimes you can't. Depends on, you know, situation. But you're supposed to study, right? Why do we study? Study to get approved. I want to pass it. So when I pass the test, it says that I'm approved. The Word of God says, study to show thyself what? Approved, a workman that needeth not be ashamed, rightly dividing. Most of the time when ministers divide the word wrongly, it's because they have not ever been students of the word. I'll tell you what's real. They're doing the best they can with what they got. They had never really been taught. And I've been there. I had to preach what I heard other preach. I had to repeat stuff I heard before. Man, I didn't know nothing else. Nobody ever taught me nothing, so I had to just repeat what I had heard. One evening in the Bible. Second Timothy 2:2. Let's look at these two scriptures. 2 Timothy 2:2. Well, which thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men, who shall be able to teach others also. Amen. So, you know, we at some point we have to be able, when we grow up, to be able to teach, you know, others. That's the plan, to learn, to be able to teach. And that don't mean you have to get up here and preach to teach. Teach me how to pray. Lord, teach us how to pray. Huh? And the reason they had a desire. Look, what the beautiful part about that is that Jesus could have just sit them down and said, look, fellas, I'm going to teach y'all how to pray. But he had to wait till they had a desire to want to learn how to pray. See, some stuff you can't teach people until they have a desire to want to learn that. Are y'all with me? You know, sometimes God has to allow, you know, your life to become influenced by demonic forces for you to say, Lord, teach me how to get rid of these devils. I'm tired of this wickedness going on. Where it said in the Bible, where it say I can get rid of these spirits, and that's what I want to learn. And when you get that desire, now the Holy Ghost can teach you. So one day they had a desire. They said, Lord, teach us how to pray. And he taught them immediately because that desire was there. And it was his desire that they know how to pray. But the reason I believe they had a desire to want to know how to pray is because they saw him praying. And they saw the power that came behind when he prayed versus when other folk prayed. Come on, somebody, because ain't the first time they heard nobody pray. Come on now. And going to the temple and all this, and they've been hearing the Pharisees and Sadducees get up with their vain repetitions and all that good stuff for a long time. But Jesus come along, and when he pray, are y'all still with me? 5,000 folk get fed when he pray. What the manner of man? Come on, somebody. When he go away to pray, he come walking on the water. Doggone it, I need to know how to pray like that. What words is he using that they ain't using? That's what I need to know. He pray for folk here, and over there, they daughter wake up, get healed, and come on, somebody. That's the kind of prayer I want. Where we at? 7, 8. Number 8, stay focused. Keep your focus on your purpose. You got to stay focused. Because the enemy always coming with distractions. He want to keep you distracted. He wants you looking at something that don't even make no difference. Don't even matter anyway. He just want to distract you. If he can get you distracted, he can get you to doubt. If he can get you to doubt, that'll keep you out right there. So we got to learn to stay focused. Stay concerned with focus on him. Focus on his purpose for my life, what he want me to do, what he is pleased with. Not what other folk. You can't please other folk anyway. You might please them today, but tomorrow it's a whole different situation because they mood done changed tomorrow. So what pleased them yesterday ain't working today because they different. But with faith, we can please him every day with faith. You hear that? With faith, we can please him every day. Stay focused. And that's easier said than done time, because issues of life have their way of hitting us in the gut, you know. You know, knock us off a little feet a little bit, you know. Hey, come on, you know, all that, you ain't never been knocked off course a little bit. We know. God understands that too. But it's a trick of the enemy to get you distracted. And I mean, let me tell you something. Enemy, he has, how would I say it? He has an inclination. He don't know all things. He can't be everywhere. He's not like God. But he watches us. Okay? And he watches us and he watches us. And he kind of pick up on routines that we do. And what he does is, he can even, by what we do, he can tell what state of spirit that we're in. Listen to me. And what he does is, he uses that against us. Let me say this too. The enemy can tell when you're about to come out of a battle situation. And God about to do something in your life. And what he wants to do is, he wants to get you distracted to make your valley situation a little bit longer. Are y'all still with me? Because he know God, you're about ready to release something to you. But if he can get you distracted, if he can get you look over here and God trying to tell you something over here, now there you go, you done missed God. Now you got to stay in the valley another month. Now he gone to the next person because he got you off for a minute. Are y'all with me? This is his tricks and his plots and his ploys. God said we can't be ignorant of the devil's devices. Don't be ignorant. Don't let him keep getting you over and over with the same thing. Learn something. That's what that really means. See how that joker came last time? Doggone, don't let him come get you the same way again. Yeah. Yeah. Be like, man, you got one by on me this time, but doggone, you ain't gonna get me again the next time the same way. You gonna have to come around another corner, man. I got your number on that now. Number 9. We got to stay with the focus. Come on, Acts 20, verse 24. Let's look at that. We're still looking at the Acts 20, verse 24. I'll give you a scripture to go with that. Acts 20, verse number 24. It says, but none of these things move me. Somebody say, come on, somebody. We got to get to where issues of life, they don't move us no more. You used to sing a song that says, I shall not be moved. What you mean? I don't care what happened, man. I'm going to stay with God. You hear me? But we kind of let issues of life keep us from being on our purpose and being on focused on what we should be focused on. So what? I lost my job. Doggone it. That the first time I ain't had no job. That don't move me, man. I'm keeping on moving forward. I know God got something else for me. Don't let him steal my joy. But none of these things move me, neither count I my life dear unto myself that I may my course with what? With joy. And the ministry which I have received of the Lord Jesus Christ to testify the gospel of the grace of God. 1 Thessalonians 5, verse number 18. 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 18. In everything. You mean in this situation I'm in now? In that too? My God. In everything. Give thanks. Why? Because it could be a whole lot worse. Are you here with me? Because it could be a whole lot worse. And that somebody got a whole lot worse than you. A whole lot worse than you. I know. Come on, somebody. I know he might not be the best husband, but doggone me, he ain't going upside your head. I know he needs some work. Come on, somebody. In all things, give with thanks. For this is what? This is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. God know what you already concerned with. He already know what's going on in your life. What he wants is for you to keep your joy in him and know that he's with you. I don't care what you're going through. He said, I never leave you or forsake you. So wherever you are, he's right there with you. Amen. If every day was a sunny day, then what's a sunny day? You got to have something to compare it with. You can't appreciate the sunshine unless you done went through the storm. Now you can really appreciate the sunshine. Why? Because you done been through the storm. Amen. Verse number 9, more done. I'm out of time anyway. Number 9, you're really growing up now. Keep your mouth shut. KYMS, keep your mouth shut. Oh, now you, come on. You're growing up now where you can do that. Keep your mouth shut. Knowing when to speak, man, that's some wisdom right there that'll help bless you. It don't even bless folk as much, other folk as much as it blesses you. I can't count time. I said to myself, man, I'm glad I didn't say nothing. I mean, come on, have you ever said that? You say nothing. Because there were times when I would, ooh-wee, you know. Said something and wrote something, all that, you know. Said something, text something, left a message and everything. Make sure you hear what I said. Huh? Sometimes as I heard Lady Ross say, she done rehearsed her stuff to tell me. She done rehearsed it. She done went over it. Been in the mirror with the facial expressions and everything. Don't act like you ain't rehearsed nothing before. Before they get there, you know what you gonna say. You know what you gonna say when they say this too, cause Negro gonna probably say this, but I'm gonna have this here for. I wish he would say that. I'm ready. Better not say. You better not say that. They would be saying, "You better not say that." So, oh no, you didn't say that. Verse 3, Proverbs 13, verse number 3. Hallelujah. What does it say? Proverbs 13, 3. Ooh, look at that. That's some wisdom for you right there. He that keepeth his mouth keepeth his life. Word of God teaches us must to be quiet. We got to learn how to be quiet. It ain't something that just comes natural. You got to learn how not to say everything you want to say. Are y'all still with me? 1 Thessalonians 5:18. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. You all right? 1 Thessalonians. No, that ain't what I want. I want Job 6:24-25. Job 6:24-25. Amen. Teach me and I will hold my tongue, and cause me to understand wherein I have erred. Verse 25. How forcible are right words, but what doth auguring reproving? Huh? See, sometimes, here's where wisdom comes in at. Sometimes the person is just saying it so they can argue with you. You're supposed to have enough wisdom and spirit of God to know this Negro just want to argue. I ain't going to even say nothing. Because it take two. They ain't want to talk nothing out. Listen to me. There's a difference. The difference now is discerning whether they want to talk it out or whether they just want to argue. And if you've been with them long, you can look at them and tell where they at. Y'all quit. Let's get y'all off the front row. Y'all clown. Look, we got to learn how to be quiet. I'm going to read that from the Message Bible, 1 Thessalonians 4. Beginning verse number 11. That's what I'm going to look at. I want to read that. 1 Thessalonians 4, verse number 11. You can put it on the screen with King James Version, though. 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 11. And that ye study to be quiet and to do your own business and to work with your own hands as we commanded you. Verse 12. That ye may walk honestly toward them that are without, and that they may have nothing, have lack of nothing. Now here's what the Message Bible, here's how the Message Bible reads. Same scripture. It says, stay calm. Here's the hard part for a lot of us with our emotions. Because when somebody tick you off, it's kind of hard to stay calm. But this is where the fruit of the Spirit comes in. Having self-control. Are y'all still with me? Amen. Stay calm. Mind your own business. Message Bible, powerful boy. You ain't got one, you ought to get you one. I'm telling you. Do your own job. You heard all this from us before, but a reminder never hurts. We want you living in a way that will command the respect of outsiders, not lying around sponging off your friends. Word of God said, you find a man that can't tame his tongue, stay away from him. That person that, I don't care what conversation you bring up, they got something to say, they know something about it, man, look. Everything, I don't care what it is, they just got something to say about it. We gotta be able to tame our tongue. Come on, even if you do know something about it, it don't mean you need to say something. Everything, man, really? And then, be honest with you, them kind of folk, you realize, you hate to see them coming sometimes. Oh, man, come on. Can't keep his mouth shut. Can't name his tongue. And that irritates us. And it irritates us. Why? Because it irritates God. God wants us to learn how to keep our mouth shut. We got to study to be quiet. Everything come up ain't supposed to come out. Some of this stuff we need to cast down, man. I ain't going to even say that. You hear me? I ain't going to even say that. It may be true, but I ain't going to even say it because it ain't going to. Come on, something. It ain't gonna help no situation. So-and-so told me this about you, but I ain't going to even tell you what they said. Man, you hear what I'm saying? I'm talking real stuff. I ain't going to even tell you that, because I ain't finna be gossiping, and plus, it's going to hurt your feelings, and you my sister, and I don't want your feelings hurt, so I'm going to stop it right here. I'm finna kill it. I'm going to kill it. You ain't got to kill it. I'm going to kill it. Man, kill that mess. They can't keep their mouth shut, but they told me, and I can keep my mouth shut, so now it's dead. It's going no further. Y'all gonna make me go past my time. Number 10. We gotta learn how to let it go so you can go on. Learn how to let go so you can go on. Let them stay back there. Let them stay right there where they are in that situation. But you got to let it go so you can go on. I ain't gonna look, y'all, this is a part of being a mature Christian to know how to do this kind of stuff. Babies don't know how to do this kind of stuff. See? This is the kind of stuff Jesus taught to the disciples. Said, look, forget about what they say. Forget about what they did to you in the past. Don't forget about that. You just keep focusing doing what I told you to do. And I got you. What happens is a lot of times we get stuck right there in that situation. Because we can't forgive and we can't let it go. That person gone. They ain't even think about you no more. You can't even sleep at night because you won't let it go. You won't. Now you can't go on because you won't let it go. Your feet stuck in the miry clay. You just, because you won't let it go. So you can go on. Remember, forgiveness ain't for them, it's for us. Hallelujah. 2 Timothy 2 and verse 3. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 2 Timothy 2 verse 3. And it says, thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Folks gonna hurt you. You ain't gonna be in a battle if you don't never get hit, nicked or nothing. Are y'all with me? You're gonna get hurt in battle. Okay? Right. You're gonna get hurt. But you gotta learn how to endure your pain, endure the pain, endure the suffering. Amen. Praise the Lord. And sometimes them, you know, them wounds are deep, and they take longer to heal. But what you got to make sure is that you're doing what it takes for it to heal. Listen to me very clearly here. Ability now that really ain't it, don't need it no more. Let me just explain this to you. There was a time when they were hurt, they were disabled. And while they were experiencing their healing, they qualified for disability. But now the healing process has taken place and they healed now. Are y'all with me? But they still on disability. And a lot of Christians be like that. God done already really healed you from that hurt. But you still holding on to it so you can get some benefits and some sympathy out of it. You ain't gotta say amen. I'm telling you what's real stuff now. Every time this situation, use that as a reason not to. It's still your crutch. It's still your disability. You got to grow up, move on. That God done even healed you from that. And there's another thing. You can't get healed from something if you won't do what the doctor say do for you to get healed. You got a whole lot of people that went back to work too soon. That's why they didn't get their healing. They didn't do what was prescribed for them to do. That's why they didn't get their healing. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And sometimes as Christians, yeah, we've been hurt by folk. Yeah, folk has cut us. Everybody been hurt. But did you do what you should do for that to heal? Well, you do, you just want disability to rest. You want to use that as a crutch. Grow up. It's his desire that you be healed. Be delivered. Hallelujah. I grow up. I can't stay a baby. I got to grow up. It's God's will that I grow up in each and every time. I come into his presence, I gotta be saying, Lord, teach me. Grow me up. Because only grown or mature get certain benefits. Listen to me. Until you become mature enough, there's a lot of benefits that God not gonna even open up to you. Because you're not mature enough to handle it. Amen. We praying for the God do for us, and he's like, you ain't mature for that. I'm not gonna give a 5-year-old keys to the house. He ain't mature enough to handle that kind of responsibility. He'll mess around and lose the key and somebody been done come up in the house. Are y'all with me? So he has to, we gotta say, we gotta get to a place of maturity where we can handle certain blessings. Come on, somebody. Privileges. You know, it's time out. We hear it all the time, but it's time out, you know, for, you know, playing. That's what little babies do. Children play. You know, it's time out for playing church and playing God and doing stuff for our own selfish motives. It's time to be about his business, what he wants done, how he wants it done. And we begin to focus more on what he wants than the things that we want. They're going to be added to us according to the word. Matthew 6:33 is plain. It says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and all these things. If they ain't being added, then there's something wrong with you.
That's why I praise you.
Are y'all with me? Because he's not a man that he should lie. His word is true.
I give you praise.
Every head bowed, every eye closed. Father, we thank you tonight for such a privilege as this to be able to come and to extend an invitation to those that don't yet know you. So Lord, we thank you that we know you and have a relationship, but now Lord, we come interceding now for those that don't. I pray now you begin to live upon their hearts, those that I hear that don't know you. that you will begin to reveal to the whole world and share your desire to have them in your hands and in your heart. There's anyone here that has never received Jesus into your heart. We want to extend an invitation for you to come and
Word
of God is here. God made it so that we can have life. And I'm just saying that
you're the heart
of He so loved the world and He saved us. And He's forever believing in us and not praying to have everlasting life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So if you're here today and you never received Him, we want to give you an opportunity to come. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. Now there may be someone here today, or I know you're here. You're saying, well, Pastor, I know I need to grow up. But this is what these 10 keys have been about, basically growing up. I know of some things I haven't been doing that I need to do. There's even some things that some of us have even stopped doing that we got to get back to doing. So if you're here tonight, you're saying, Pastor, that's me. I need help. I need help in growing up and living in a mature Christian. But I'm going to pray that with you tonight. You receive some principles and keys, but it's not just enough to hear. We have to be doers. So if you need the strength and the power to do it, then come on down to the altar. I'm going to pray that God would empower us with the strength and the will and the way to do His will. Stay focused, because a lot of us being distracted by little stuff that don't even matter. Hallelujah. You know, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That's it. That's the altar call. That's you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. There's a way, the Bible says, there's a way that seems right to a man, but the end of it is destruction. Sometimes we can feel like we're doing right things good. If it's not in God's will, and going to end up in destruction. That's it. That's only one way for it to end. To get back into the will and the way of the Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we come to you tonight in the name of Jesus. First, thanking you for the word of God, for the foundation that we stand upon, that your word is true. And Lord, we thank you that we thank you for giving us such a ministry that gives us the teaching to help us to grow up and to be Christians that are mature and know how to live for you according to the word, not according to what people say, or not according to tradition, but according to what you say in your word. For Jesus, we know that you rebuked the tradition in the Bible. So Lord, we don't want to be traditional. We want to be mature. So Lord, continue to teach us the ways. Empower us with your Holy Spirit that gives us the ability. He also leads and guides us into all truths according to your word. So, Lord, for every lie, every fable, everything in our lives that's not of you is not true, we pray in Jesus' name that you will remove it in the name of Jesus. And not only that you will remove it, but you will replace it with your truth, your purpose that you have for our lives. We want to be in your will. We want to be in your way. Lord, we pray now that you will forgive us of all of our sins, the sins that we have committed, even the things that we have omitted to do. Our sin of commission and omission, Lord, forgive us in Jesus' name. And set us back in right standing with you. Hallelujah, this day, in the name of Jesus. Now I decree that there is power in your heart. I decree manifold power in your spirit to be able to overcome the adversary with his plots, with his ploys, with his tricks. I'm going to get you distracted in the name of Jesus. No longer will you be bamboozled by that again. Because now you are wiser, amen, you're better, and you're stronger because of the word that came forth in Jesus' name. Say in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen.
praise the Lord on tonight. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I was going to move on, but I do need to pause and open the doors of the church. Amen. Amen. Perhaps you heard a word. You thought you had salvation and come to find out you really didn't. Amen. And you would like to accept salvation on tonight. Doors of the church is open. Or perhaps you're already saved. But you know that your walk with Christ is not where it should or was. And you have slidden back. You are in a backslidden state. And you want to rededicate, recommit, fall in love with your first love again. Doors of the church is open for you. Or perhaps you got a relationship. You where you should be, but you do not have a covering. And you would like to unite with Kingdom Connections Church. Or if you want to join another church, but we want you here at Kingdom Connections. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Come on and give God a hand praise. Welcome to Kingdom Connections Church, where Jesus is Lord. Where Jesus is. Amen. Where Jesus is, here are your weekly announcements. On tomorrow night, that time is at 10 p.m., we will be calling in for a prayer. Dial in number 712-432-0255, access code 4010. Oh, what a time we had on last Thursday night. Amen. And looking forward to tomorrow night being empowered through prayer. Tune in to KJIW 94.5. At 8:45 every Sunday morning in Kingdom Perspectives, our weekly radio broadcast, where Apostle Ross, by way of the Holy Spirit, empowers the masses to live their life for Christ. Faith comes by hearing the word of God. Amen. It's casual attire for the summer months at Kingdom Connections Church, where Jesus is. Remember, it's not what's on you, it's what's in you. Amen. Leadership meeting this Saturday. That time is at 9 a.m. All leaders, ministers, deacons, and auxiliary heads are to attend this meeting. All outreaches will remain on break for the summer months. We will resume on October 1st. That's Superman, Boys, well, Superman, Wonder Woman, boom, all that good stuff. Amen. Amen. Morning Star MB Church annual choir day is Sunday, July the 21st. That's this Sunday. That time is at 3 p.m. Things still have a praise. Apostle Ross will bring the sermon, and Kingdom Connections Sanctuary Choir is on for special music. Kingdom Connections Church is the guest church. Enter your child while you have time for the Mr. and Mrs. KCC contest. If your child is 0 to 4 years of age, please see Elder Foreman or Minister Brister for necessary forms for your child. King and Queen will be announced on the fourth Sunday, which is July the 28th. Grand prize will be given. Thank you in advance for supporting the ministry that supports you. Kingdom Connections Church has begun a mission department, and meetings are held one Monday a month at 5:30 p.m. in the Hal Johnson Community Center. Please see Sister Berta if you are interested. Wow, worship on Wednesdays. Intercessory prayer begins at 6:30 p.m. Worship begins at 7 p.m. Please come out and learn how to be God's disciples. Our birthdays for the month of July. July the 4th, Ashley Carlton. July the 6th, Teresa Foreman. July the 7th, Ashanti Turner. July the 9th to Sandra Turner. July the 10th was Lady Ross. Somebody let her know the 10th has passed. We're looking forward to 2014. Amen. July 11th, Kaylee Randall. Oh, yesterday, Mamie Bonner was July the 12th. That was not yesterday. It was, amen. Amen. Breonna Berry, that's today. Throw your hand up, Bree. Happy birthday, Bree. On tomorrow, Sister Faith Williams. Sonia Ross on the 22nd. Caden Carter on the 21st. And truck driver Chris Stanley Jr. on the 24th. Oh, wait, no, that's something else. Happy anniversary on the 7th to Brother Jim and Stephanie Walker. On the 10th, Apostle Keith and Lady Donita Ross. Lady Ross doing the most tonight. Amen, Brother Joe and Sister Teresa Orr on the 10th, and Brother Calvin and Lois Pascal on the 29th. Please join us for Food Fun Fellowship as we celebrate Sister Candace. That's this Saturday. That time is at 4 o'clock. We're going to be in the Hal Johnson Community Center. Candace going off to school. She's going to Philander, and she need everything. Amen. Amen. Can't go wrong with a gift card. Praise God. But whatever you bring, she's going to appreciate it. Amen. Amen. To Pastor Keith Ross and Kingdom Connections Church family. This is from New Bethel. New Bethel is having their pastor and wife anniversary on August the 4th. It's at 11 o'clock and 3 o'clock. We are invited. Music in the Park. This is going to be July the 27th at 12 noon in Caldwell, Arkansas. They're asking, this is what's going to be going on. Music in the Park. Everything ain't to be read. Kay, keep your mouth shut. Everything ain't to be read out loud. Amen. We want to encourage our members to purchase a CD or DVD of this service or a past service. We are called to be witnesses in the kingdom of God. So let's start by spreading the gospel one message at a time. These are your weekly announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly. Thank you again for attending this worship service at Kingdom Connections Church, where Jesus is. Let us stand. Yes. Amen. Let us stand. Come on, brother. Oh, there's food in the kitchen if you would like it. Go on back there and...